Hello, and welcome to the Counterattack playthrough series. We're playing Barbarossa, Kiev to Rostov, 1941. Specifically, scenario number one, Rostov Redeemed, and we're about to start the second turn of the scenario. In terms of the overall campaign, it's actually considered game turn 81, but it's the second turn of the scenario. It's November 29th to the 30th, 1941. First thing we're going to do is we're going to process the strategic segment, and that starts with the weather determination phase. We look in the turn box, and we can see the climate conditions frost. Last turn it was frost as well. This last turn the weather was fixed by the scenario rules as frost. We're going to roll now. So this is a climate condition, and we're going to roll for the weather. So let's go ahead and get the weather chart somewhere around here. Yeah, okay. So we're going to roll a 1 dice 10. I got a 5. So the current climate is frost. I got a 5, frost. There are some rules like for lingering snow and lingering mud, but we don't have any mud or snow, so nothing to worry about. So it's frost again. Thought I'd point out on these turns, there's also a little square in the lower right hand corner. That is the historical weather, and you can choose to play with that as a optional rule. So that's the weather phase. We have frost again. Before we go into the next phase, I figure I should let you know that I figured out the how victory conditions work for this scenario. So I happen to know that there are 6 points worth of victory point cities. I looked up on the chart in Rostov at this date, each hex is worth 2. And then scenario rules for Bolshie Sally and Sultan Sally, which I think is in there, are 1 each. So there's 6 points available. Well, the Germans control them at the beginning of the scenario. But I didn't really know, like, well, how do you win or lose? So it's actually this chart here. So we go ahead and look at scenario one. And these numbers line up with what I figured out in terms of how many points there are. So if the Axis can get 6 or more points, they have an operational victory. So I guess they can get more than 6 by destroying enough enemy units. So the Soviets will get a marginal win if they have 4 points or more. So, and then there's another range, so the historical result's 3. So, figure that out. Okay, next we do the supply determination phase. Since this scenario cuts out a lot of the supply rules, there's not a lot to do here. It does say on turn 81, which is this turn, and turn 82, the Axis are now in out of supply. So that's sort of a shortcut rather than dealing with supply rules. So I'll just put this marker here. You're supposed to put it on each unit that's out of supply, but they're all out of supply. And it just has a little reminder, -2 movement points, no reaction, no fire, no overrun. Okay, so there's that. And there's a bunch of things else we would do if this was a full scenario, but it's not. But one thing we do is check for Axis fuel shortages. So each formation that's motorized or a panzer division, so here's 13th Panzer, these greenish guys. This is what, 60th Mountain maybe? So there's that formation. And then SS LAH, I guess that's Liebstandart Adolf Hitler. That's one as well. So we need to roll a die for each of them to see if they have fuel shortages. We'll start with the SS, what is that, brigade. I got a 1. I'm looking on the Axis fuel shortage chart. 5 or less passes. +2 during mud. Logistics pause. If 2 or more units of the division are out of supply, +1. Well, there's only 1 unit in this division, so that doesn't count. Okay, I won't show you that for each of these. But so this guy passes. Now, if he had failed, this core unit, it's not part of the division, would also have been out of fuel. Okay, let's go with 13th Panzer. More than 1 unit is out of supply, so we add 1. I got a 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. So it fails. So it has a supply shortage. And, or I should say it's a fuel. They're out of fuel. So we'll go ahead and throw some of these. Well, I need to go find the right chip to put it on it. But we'll go ahead and mark each of these guys. And we'll do the 60th mountain or motorized. I'm not sure where the M is. Rolled a 3 plus 1 since there's more than one unit. That's a 4. It's less than 5, so they pass. So let me go get the markers for the 13th Panzer. Okay, I found them. They say fuel shortage, division out of supply. So marked each of the guys with the 13th Panzer. This guy here is stacked with a core unit, so that core unit is also out of fuel, though it's not motorized. So, or I guess it doesn't really matter. But basically, none of these guys can move. They can advance after combat and retreat, but they can't move. And they can attack normally. So that is the supply determination phase. Next, we would do the replacement phase, except this scenario doesn't use that phase, skips it. Then we would do the reinforcement withdrawal phase as well. This scenario does not take part in that. So then we move to the air readiness phase. Readiness phase, we see if the aircraft improve their condition. For example, this bomber here, which flew last time, is in the flown box. Well, it can't do missions until it's in the ready box. And so we see here, we need to roll a die. 1 to 8, it moves to the ready box. 9 or more, does not. We add 1 if it's frost, which it is. So go ahead and roll. Got an 8 plus 1 is 9. It's too bad. It's going to remain here. The next phase is the Axis air interdiction phase. However, in this scenario, there are no Axis air units, so we can skip that. So that ends the strategic segment, and now we go into the Axis player segment. The first thing we do is the Axis movement phase. So Axis units in their movement phase, and notice that contrary to the Soviet phase, it's Axis movement phase first. Then it'll be Axis combat, and then Axis motorized movement. And the Soviets were reversed. So they get to move any and all units. Now, of course, they're severely hampered by being out of supply. They all have -2 movement points. Can't do overruns, which is combat during movement, so I won't get to show you that. Plus these guys that have fuel shortages can't move at all. So got just a really bad situation. So these cavalry units infiltrated in, like to try to push them back out, especially off of, Sultan Sally, which is worth a point. We got these Axis units here on Rostov. I feel like they need to stay there. I mean, that's 2 points per hex. There's only 6 points in the game, so whoever takes those hexes wins the game, basically. Got this large force pouring in from the northeast. Not sure what to do here. I could try to attack. Problem is my maneuverability is so low, I can't, like, shift forces around. So one thing I know I want to do is let's move this artillery back 1. Is that what I want to do? I pull it back, its range is 2. It can support attacks along here, but it won't be able to help these guys. That's okay. No, it's not. We'll keep it here. We're going to be attacking, so hopefully we'll push these guys out. These guys can't move. These guys can't move. I do suspect this guy here could move if I wanted him to. I would double check if I cared. It's not motorized, so that's why I say that, but it's quite possible this fuel shortage affects it. So who else would I want to move out? Like this guy. I feel like I want to attack here. Maybe this guy would pull back like this and attack here. This is scary. Can't even get 1-to-1 odds on that, but this artillery could help get it to 1-to-1. Maybe this guy here could attack him. That would, well, we're out of supply, so I'm not sure how that affects attacks. But if it doesn't affect, that'd be a 3-1 right there. If I had this guy help, I can get a Panzer Division Integrity bonus for that would give us a minus one. But then I wouldn't be attacking over here. An alternative is these two guys could both attack here with the Panzer Integrity bonus. This guy come here. I think that's what we'll do. Just trying to get an idea of how I want to move. So I guess I'm the only move I'm going to do, I'm going to try to shore up a little bit here. So this guy's going to go here. It's one. And then it's going to go two. And then plus one for the zone of control. So three. Yeah. Germans are just going to get destroyed here. Okay. So now we do attack declaration. This might be silly, but I'm going to attack this salient to try to push it back. I have, yeah, actually, let's make sure I can actually do this. Three attack odds. Or three attack strength against four. So it's better than 1-4, so that is legal. I will probably throw this guy in, these guys in to help. Okay, then that guy. His attack is three against one, so that works. These two guys will attack this guy here. He's a two defense. This guy's two. Two, so, and whatever's underneath there, so it's at least, 1-4. And that's about it. Yeah. So then we do the Soviet reaction phase. They are not as flexible as the Germans, as I guessed in the first turn, and that they can only react units, motorized units, that are within range of an operational headquarters. So they have some motorized units up here. And the range is 1, 2, 3, 4, so they cannot order them to react. And I'd be able to do one per command point. So I can also issue additional retreat or no retreat orders, one per command point within range. The rules almost make it sound like I could use this point for a no retreat order and also to activate. Motorized units and one other thing, but I'm gonna have to ask online. It seems like the one point is one point, and I shouldn't be able to do more than one thing. But anyway, I don't want to issue any no retreat orders. We might get pushed back a little, but that's okay because we got. I feel like the Soviets have the advantage here. They can also designate artillery to be taking part. Now this guy got pushed. Gotta show you who he is. This rocket artillery got pushed back last turn, so he can't help. But this guy can. He's got a range of two. I will go ahead and throw him on top of the headquarters just to help me remember. And I'm gonna designate him. Well, unfortunately, now that I'm looking at it, he's not in range of any of the declared attacks. So doesn't matter. Likewise, this guy's not in range of any of the declared attacks. Let's see what we got there. Nope. Okay, so no artillery support. Oh, and there's another one up here, still out of range. Okay. Then we go to the Axis combat phase. Both sides can send in combat air support missions, but Axis have no air and the Soviets' aircraft are not ready. Okay, now we're gonna process the battles. So, which one do I want to do first? Maybe this one here. We have a armored unit. Yeah, we'll do this. So we got three attacking one in a town. A town has no defensive benefit unless it's mud or snow. So that's 3-1. Do I want to throw artillery in? I'm going to save that artillery for a different attack. Normally we would decide to put attack into attack supply, but that is all attack supply rules are ignored in this scenario. Just looking at the sequence of play here, making sure I got everything here. Okay, so right now we're looking at 3-1. Let me get the combat results table and look up what kind of modifiers we have, if any. Okay, so there's no negatives for combat. If you're out of supply or have a fuel shortage, the exception is you cannot use your divisional integrity die roll modifier, which I haven't used yet, and I can't use it here. So I'll discuss what that is when it's applicable. So I'm rolling on the 3-1 column. Rolled a 6. No modifiers. So that's an R result. Defender retreat. Interesting. It looks like it could retreat into this. Oh, it has to go 2. So I think it's going to retreat through here. Since it's going through friendlies, it can ignore enemy zones of control. So it's pulled back to here. And 13th, the 4th Regiment of the 13th Panzer could advance after combat. And yeah, I think it will. It's going to advance into Sultan Sali. So the Germans regain a point. They're back at 6 points. Okay, so we have 2 more attacks to resolve. Let's do this attack. So we'll go ahead and attack with this guy. And with this guy. So I should probably look at the numbers. 2. And 2. It's 4. 5. So we have 5 coming in. Against 2. In clear. Okay, so that's 2-1. Is that right? Yes. No die roll modifiers. Go ahead and roll. Got a 3. That's defender takes 1 step loss. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have advanced those cavalry up, but I was thinking they would cause some mayhem. So this guy takes a step loss. Still survives, though. Okay. By the way, just to clarify, when this guy advanced after combat, it's okay, even though he's out of fuel. I guess it's a fuel shortage, so they saved their fuel for the advance. Okay, one last attack here. Let's take a look at what we have here. I think it's in clear terrain, yes. We got 2 cavalry units, a total of 4 defense strength. We're attacking with 3. So that's not quite 1-1. But I'm going to throw in this artillery support. Now, you would normally have to do attack supply to do that. Kind of hard to say how to navigate this scenario since it's got special rules. For example, it says don't ignore attack supply. Okay, so maybe I use the artillery even though it's supposed to have attack supply. And then when you're out of supply, you can't use your artillery unless it's paid to have attack supply. So do I just say that you can't use the artillery, or since I'm ignoring anything about attack supply, do I get to use it? I guess I might be cheating here, but I'm just going to use it, and someone can correct me if my interpretation's wrong. So we got 1-1 attack coming in. Now, there's this concept of divisional integrity bonus, and that's when you have a bunch of units of the same division attacking together, and there's certain rules about it, but it only applies as long as at least 1 panzer division's in the attack, and there's not. Okay, so we got 1-1. Here we go. Got a two, and German's rolling really well. It's a one star and a two. So we'll go ahead and do the defender's two first. So that's two step losses. Go ahead and take one from this guy and one from this guy. Okay, the attacker is a one star. I need to remind myself about the star part. Yeah, so the star is the attacking force must take an extra step loss if it attacks without attack supply. Well, ignore attack supply in this scenario. Or it attacks a non-destroyed enemy fortification, or it is making a mandated attack. It also denotes armor attrition or engineer loss. So what that means is if I was getting an armor combined arms bonus or using engineers in the assault, they would take potentially take a hit. So I can ignore the star, basically, is what that boils down to, and take the one step loss. So who do we take it from? I guess we'll take it from this guy. That really opens up my northern edge, doesn't it? You know, and I intended to attack with these guys too. Oh well, let's screw up. I'm not going to roll it back. So, lose this guy, or this guy. If I lose him, oh, yeah, Germans are just toast. Okay, I'm going to lose this guy, even though he's more powerful. Okay. So, that's all the attacks. Yeah. So, next up, Axis Motorized Movement Phase. In this phase, all motorized units and cavalry may move at half movement. Note, that's a little different from the Soviet one, where the Soviet motorized units can go at full movement. So, really, these guys down here are stuck. Well, I guess they could infiltrate out, but I want them to hold Rostov. Ever so slight chance I can keep holding the scenario by just holding on down here. These guys can't move, so this guy could move. Does he want to move? Can pull back here. But then that opens up this artillery to be attacked. This is horrible. I think he's just going to stay there, delaying action, sacrifice himself. Okay. Then we do the Axis engineering phase, but there's nothing they're allowed to do in this scenario. All the rules are stripped away. Next is the Soviet player segment. We start with the Soviet motorized movement phase, and I should remind myself that are in this segment by flipping this over to the Soviet turn side. So Soviet motorized movement segment. Remember, there's four categories of things that can move in this segment. Axis, they can move motorized units and cavalry. Soviets have four types of movement. So let's go ahead and do the motorized guys first. I remember there's some up here. They can go their full movement. Yes. So this guy can move at five. There's another one in here that can move at five. Well, they can't move very far because there's a zone of control right here. So I guess they'll move up. Maybe they'll move up, knock him out of the way or kill him, and then move into Bolshaya Sally in the movement phase. So here we go like this. Okay. Now for cavalry, which is another category. Cavalry moves at half. So I think we're going to go ahead and throw him up here too. What's the stacking situation? We got five. Any cavalry in here? I think I lost a lot of my cavalry by overextending myself a bit. So here's some cavalry here. It could infiltrate, I believe. Let me see. Movement procedures allowed are reinforcement entry, one hex movement, armored train, which we haven't seen yet, overrun, and motorized infiltration. Let me see if motorized infiltration includes cavalry. Okay, the cavalry is not considered motorized, so it can only infiltrate during its normal movement phase. But I did cheat back here, so let me put this guy back here. Motorized movement during this phase is only for units with a movement factor of 7 or more. I misread that. That is motorized infiltration movement, which is when you're sneaking through a zone of control. So this is just normal movement, so they're okay to move forward. Okay. I didn't cheat after all. Okay, so let's see what else we have down here. There's some more cavalry down here. They can only infiltrate during their normal movement phase. So I think we are good with that. Does the headquarters want to spend a command point? And it was here to order a unit to move up. I think the answer is maybe. let's see, the headquarters is here. 1, 2, 3, 4. It could order a unit up here to move up. A non-motorized unit. We'll have this guy move up. What's he have here? So yeah, we'll put 8 stacking points there. Okay. And then headquarters, regardless of number of command points remaining, can always issue an order to a guards unit. So this guy can go 1. Well, we're on a road here, so it's, I guess it's 1 plus 1 for the zone of control. Okay. I think that's the Soviet motorized movement phase. Now for their attack declaration phase. We'll definitely attack in this guy. We got plenty. Got 3 guys here. But if they attack this guy, remember I have to be able to, attack. Like if he attacks here, then I also have to attack these guys. Although this one doesn't have a zone of control. Really though, I need to hammer Rostov. So I think this stack is going to attack here. In fact, it probably could have overrun last turn. Let's see. I think it needs 7 attack points. Oh, doesn't have it. Okay. So these two guys here. We'll attack here. So that's plenty of odds ratio. These two guys here will attack here. I think this guy will attack over here as well, which means, well, here I should probably be declaring these, huh? So because this guy is attacking over here, I need to attack this guy. So I'll have this. These units here attack. They have an attack strength of 3. His strength is 2, so that's plenty. Okay. Now this guy is not attacking anyone because if he contributed to any of these attacks, then these guys would have to be attacked. So yeah. That's what we're gonna do. Now for the German reaction phase. Remember, out of supply units cannot do reaction movement. But they can react. Now I'm looking at this out of supply thing here and it says no fire. I need to go see what that means. Well, it doesn't really say anything about no fire. It says artillery units cannot defend when out of supply. They cannot contribute their support to a defense. And then they can also not contribute it to an attack unless they're in attack supply. And that's where I cheated and said, okay, attack supply rules don't apply, therefore it's okay for it to attack. So I'm going to say this guy cannot assist anyone. No one can do reaction movement, so that's about it. That's just, there's nothing. I could issue no retreat orders. That's scary. Do I want no retreat orders here? I could also issue an additional retreat order here. And it makes it move 3 hexes instead of 2 and retreat. And the enemy gets to choose the direction. But you add 1 to the die roll. Something like that. Or maybe it's you take 1 less step loss. Yeah. And it basically it's a defensive benefit to declare an additional retreat. Yeah. That's We're going to do that. Declare an additional retreat here. Now these guys are under attack. Problem is they're out of supply and fuel shortage. I could have them make an additional retreat too, give them a little help. If these guys might cross the river. Well, I should play with all the tools I have available. We're going to try that. Okay, Hitler would not like that. Yeah, okay. That's the German reaction. Okay, now for the Soviet combat phase. We're going to... we don't have any aircraft to go in, so we'll go ahead and just designate attack, or take part in... follow through on our orders. So I just want this stack to attack these guys here. Our attack strength is... 5. Defense strength is 1. They have issued an additional retreat order. I don't see anything else going on. Defender out of supply subtracts 1 from the die roll, which is bad for the defender. So here we go. Rolled a 10, so the Germans lucked out. It goes down to a 9. A 9 on 5-1 is a retreat. So it's an additional retreat. So the Soviets get to choose the direction, and it has to retreat 3. I mean, there's not a whole lot of choices here, so I guess they'll have it to go 1, 2, 3, way back here. Just a reminder, this is just to symbolize all these units are out of supply. Okay, so let's advance these guys forward. Okay. Next attack. I think we'll do these two guys attacking this space with these guys as well. So let's check it out. We have 4 defense in a major city. Major city defense is +2 die roll modifier if Soviet defender. B +1 if it's an Axis defender. Attacking armor is halved, which I don't think I have any. No combined arms. Zone of controls do not extend into. Okay, reading the combat results table. So this is 4. What do we got coming in? We got 3. Oh. 3, I'm just checking the terrain there. 3 from clear, no like rivers or anything being fought over. Here's 2, but they're attacking across a major river, so it goes down to 1. So we have 3, 4. Oh, this isn't going to be as good as I thought it was. And then attacking across a river. So 4 is half to 2. So that's a total of 6 attack, +3 from this rocket artillery support. And I think the Soviets, since this is stacked with the headquarters, this guy can support this attack too. So I think I'm going to have it go here. So we got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we got 9 attack going in. Rolled a 5. It's -1 for these guys being out of supply. What did I have? I had 9-4. So that's basically 2-1. Rolled a 5 on 2-1, -1, that's 1-1. I was hoping for something better. So, what do we got here? We'll lose this guy dead. This guy manages to hold on to Rostov. The attackers must lose a unit. those guys are on the other side of the river, so I want them there. I like this NKVD guy. Though this guy's better, so we'll lose it. Okay. Yeah. Okay, now for this attack here. Okay, what does the defense have? They are in Rostov, major city, 3 defense. Attackers are attacking from clear. Hold on, I forgot something in that last attack. In that last attack, I forgot to add the Soviet defensive die roll modifier for being in a major city, which is +2, so that would have changed the roll to 1 star, so the Soviets still would have lost a unit. R for the defender, so retreat, not a step loss. Honestly, that is seems better for the Germans, so let's see. Yeah, let me just do some double checking, make sure I got this right. Yeah, so that retreat is devastating. So you can retreat through a zone of control. So what we would do is take a loss, I believe, while moving through the zone of control. Then we'd roll a die to see the fate of the other steps that might be alive, and they might die. However, you can never end your movement, which it would have to be here, still in an enemy zone of control. So these guys are just... My understanding of the rules is these guys are destroyed. They go to the cadre box, which is irrelevant in this game because you can't rebuild units. Wow, okay. Soviets advance after combat. See, what do we have here? Guess that guy's going to defend from this direction for the moment. So, at a minimum, this guy's going in. I'm adjusting victory points. That's 2 victory points for the Soviets. So, we're at 4 victory points total in the Germans' favor, which, if I recall, is a Soviet marginal victory. I want to get more guys in here, but... Yeah, let's see. The Soviets still going to have a chance to move something, but... Yeah. We'll move this guy over. This weak cavalry. Okay. Back to this attack. Okay, so we have 5 coming in. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we got 10 attacking. 3. That's 3-1. No artillery. Soviets get +2 for defending, or German. Hold on. I guess I'm tired. Screwed up that same battle again. I gave the Germans the Soviet defensive modifier of +2. They only get +1. So let's see. That results in 2-1, not 1-star R. Okay, let's do this again. Sorry for the horrible mistakes, but I want to get it right. So, put these guys back. The attacker already took 1 loss, but they're supposed to take 2 losses. So maybe this cavalry will go. And then the defender takes 1 loss. See, that's a 2 defense. This is a 3 defense. Flipping over goes to 2, so we'll, seems to be the best choice there. Okay, so that's not too bad for the Germans after all. Sorry for that big screw up. Okay, back to here. We had 10 attacking 3, 3-1, -1 for the out of supply effects, +1 for Germans defending a major city. So that's net of 0. We'll get this one right. So I roll a 4 on 3-1. That's 1-1. Both sides take a loss. I was hoping to push them out of here. So who's taking the loss? This guy is. And then Soviets, they'll have this guy take the loss. Ooh, he's gonna go away though. This guy'll take it. Okay. Well, they're whittling away on Rostov, but it's still held. Last attack. These guys attacking here. We got three. Oh, and actually, they can call in the support. So three, four. Oh, and I forgot to use support over here. Oh well. Too many mistakes. Forgot to put that back there. Okay, so two defense and a clear, doesn't matter. We got three attack across a normal river. It's going to be a plus one die roll modifier, which gets canceled out by the minus one of Germans being out of supply. So we're doing a 3-2 plus one, so 2-1. Yeah, let's see. I'm also in swamp. Okay, yeah, I seem to remember something bad about swamp. Frost have if attacking from. Okay, so it's 1-1. Net. Got an 8. 8 on 1-1. Retreat of the attacker. And they have a star. It doesn't affect us. So these guys have to retreat. So I guess they'll go across the bridge like this. Okay. I don't really care about that attack. It's just to basically attack this guy in the flank so it can't, these guys are free to attack this way. Okay. So these orders were not needed. All right. That is the Soviet combat phase. Now we go into the Soviet movement phase. One thing I forgot to do is this artillery was ordered in the motorized movement phase, so it should have been marked as activated, so it can't move during this phase. And in this phase, motorized units move at half movement. So what do we got here? These guys, half movement, 2.5, they're gonna go 1, 2. There is no zone of control cast by this guy. In fact, they could have just gone 1. Because he has no zone of control. So they just took Bolshia Sally. So another point for the Soviets. You know, I think this entire stack is just going to go forward like that. Let's see. These guys go 2.5. Yeah, so these guys will go like this. This cavalry. Just trying to see how far I should go. Maybe it'll come back here. Just kind of try to interdict things. Maybe over here. So this would be 1, 2, 3. Okay. Let's move this guy. 1, 2, 3. I can't go there 4 because I would be going into an enemy zone of control. I would need 5. So we'll stop here. This guy go here. Keep those guys there for the assault on Rostov. Let's move these guys back. I actually probably just want to abandon this section over here. So maybe they'll come over here. Let's see. 1, 2, 2.5, 3.5. That guy there. This artillery way up here. 1, 2. Yeah, he'll go there. So he can bombard here. He can bombard here. We got that rocket artillery in there. I guess I'm cool with that. So next we do the Soviet engineering phase. There's really nothing to do for this scenario. Then we go into the Soviet surrender phase. This is like one of those unclear things about this scenario. You have to be able to trace your Russians to, or Soviets, to major cities. Well, there's only one major city because we're on this little tiny map. I'm going to assume there's a major city off the map from here because none of these guys are surrounded, so they can all trace, so they're not going to try to surrender. That ends the Soviet player segment. Then we go to the game turn interface where we just do a little bookkeeping. We remove activation markers, so we'll do that. Then we move the game turn marker to the next turn. So that was November 29th and 30th.